Welcome back to Hylics. So I've got to say something important before I continue. I actually already tried to record this episode. I actually recorded this entire episode. It took about an hour. And I actually finished the game. However, I only thought I was recording. I actually wasn't. I use OBS to record, and I accidentally was in preview mode instead of recording mode. So I played it as if I was recording, but I wasn't. Needless to say, I was pretty freaking frustrated right after I finished. You know, I breathed a sigh of relief, it was all done and everything went well, and you know, I looked over at my OBS window and I realized it wasn't recording, and then I thought, oh my god. So I'm starting up here right where I left off in the last episode. However, I have already continued, and so at this point this is not going to be a blind playthrough. So I'm not used to dealing with this. I'm not really sure what's going to happen. Obviously I'm not going to pretend that this is a blind playthrough anymore, so yeah, we'll just see what happens. This episode's going to be a lot shorter than it was before. Before it was like an hour, but now I know exactly where to go. So yeah, this is going to be a weird change in tone from a blind playthrough to a not blind playthrough. But we'll work with it. Alright, I love the line that this person says. I've died a lot here. I call this place the Hall of Deadly Statues. I'm strengthening my leg muscles so I can run past them. Yeah, so that's why that person is like gyrating back and forth, is to strengthen their leg muscles. So that they can run past the huge statues that are about to start chasing me right now! Oh, there we go. If they touch you, you die. Thankfully, this time I know where to run. Oh god, okay. Let's try that again in a second. Oops. I think I just took two naps. Okay, once more. Okay, there we go. Now we're back to this strange character that we keep seeing appearing again and again. It's kind of like the intermission character. And that text is totally nonsense, by the way, so I'm just gonna skip it. It feels weird to say the stuff that I've already said before. Because I feel like I'm repeating myself, but I know you didn't actually hear me before, so I guess I'll say it again. I love these act intermission screens and how they just keep getting more and more buttons. So many bloopy things. I like bloopy things. Okay. So yeah, that takes us to here. Which means for the first time, I get to use the airship. So let's summon it. Alright, there we go. So it's just like the boat, except way better, because it means we can go to places that don't have docks. I'm trying to remember where I went before. I guess I just need to go to places that don't have docks, yeah. So this place doesn't have a dock, but I have already been here before because of the teleporter that's on there. Let's go here. Excuse me. Bloop. Juice pack, new ability here. Oh yeah, so this ability is illusion form, which you can't actually use during combat. And it doesn't actually cost anything. All it does is transform your entire party temporarily into random entities. Like this. There we go. Now I'm a splotch, the person behind me is a splotch, the person behind that is, I guess, just a person. And then the last person is a squirrel. Because why not? Psst, hey, I've got horse food. Might be persuaded to part with it for 3,000 bucks. Yeah, I'll take it. Yeah, so we got horse food, roach food, and squirrel food now. And no, there's nothing in the toilet up there, if you're wondering that. Whoops. Alright, so yeah, you can use the horse food, and the squirrel food, and the roach food back home. There's a squirrel. Let's feed it. Acquired head squirrel. There's a horse. Come back here. Hanorf? Give horse food. Acquired horse. That's right, you feed the horse and you acquire it. Oh yeah, and the vegetable garden does grow back. Which I think I mentioned before was something I was wondering about, whether the vegetable garden would grow back when you went back there. And it does. Alright, now we gotta feed the roaches, which are in my bathroom. Oh yeah, there's also kittens, which weren't there before, and they all have the same face as the big cat. Meow. Also, they're adorable and they follow you. Look at him. Alright, let's give the roaches roach food, which makes them talk to you. Thanks for the snack. You can have this. Get a shield. And get some armor. Yeah, unfortunately, that doesn't use up all the food, so there's still, I believe, one of each type of food left, even after doing that. Yeah, one squirrel, one roach, one horse. So I guess there's a squirrel and a roach and a horse somewhere else, but I don't know where. I don't remember. Let's see, where else? Oh, this tower. You must be the new foreman. Check in with Clawman before you head to the lab. Alright, so yeah, we gotta go check in with Clawman, who is named appropriately because he is a claw man. And he wants a password. Nice to finally meet you. If you'll just give me the password, I can get you set up in the lab. Alright, the only problem is we don't know the password. I don't know if it's even possible to possibly know the password, so I'm just gonna try random ones again and see if it works this time, because before I never gave the right password and I ended up having to fight him. Theory Blast. Nope. Blue Beast. Sustenance Thinly. Nope, didn't work. Alright, let's fight. Alright, so Clawman is very, very strong. Let's open up with Mystic Meat to ward ourselves. And then let's just beat up on it with Space Shurikens. And Mini Leech. And Partial Destruct. Let's go ahead and do a health chant, get everybody healed up a bit. Keep doing space shurikens. Normal attack for you. Once again, partial destruct. Ooh, so much for that partial destruct. Lungorma's dead. Let's use a warm burrito on Pongorma. Space Shuriken, normal attack. Health chant. Normal attack. Normal attack. And partial destruct. Okay, should be almost dead. I think it's got like 300 hit points left. So use Space Shuriken and then just normal attacks. That should kill it, I think. Yep, there we go. Alright, so that allows us to now go in here. Before he wouldn't allow us into the lab, but now we can go. And in the lab there's a bunch of weird vats full of highly monetized entities, as I believe one of these people say. Was it you? Yeah, I selected these specimens for their exceptionally high monetization potential. Which is very true, because if you, like, liquefy them or whatever this does, it causes a pile of money to appear on the floor. And it's an incredibly large amount of money. 250,000 to be exact, for each one. So with this you'll have all the money you need. And you might ask, what would we need that much money for? It's not just for buying armor and stuff. Nope, you actually need a bunch of money to buy a spaceship key, because we need to go to space. You'll see. Yeah, this is awkward, because at this point, this video is kind of like a walkthrough. I know it's weird, I don't know. I can't think of any other thing to do. I know I'm kind of spoiling what's going to happen in the future, but, like, I can't pretend I don't know what's going to happen. Alright, let's take it over to the spaceship. Actually, wait a minute. No, this is one other place we have not gone. Yeah. So this is where you can go to party. As a matter of fact, you can actually play the instrument. If you talk to this fish, it gives you a music tutorial. So keys 1 through 4 to play notes, key 5 to change the sound of your instrument. And if you use your bandmates, you can make them play music too. Like that. And we can play. It's a really cool idea, but I can't really actually, with only 4 different things to play, and plus, it's really hard to stay in time because it's kind of delayed when the sound happens after you press the key, so it's really hard to stay in time and it's hard to make anything that sounds good. But it's a really cool idea to actually be able to play an instrument. It's really neat. I forgot what ability you actually get here. Oh, it's dissection, isn't it? Yeah, dissect. Alright, let's blow this joint. To the spaceship. So this is the spaceship up here. But to be able to use the spaceship, you need a key. And to get the key, you talk to the hot dog vendor, who sells hot dogs and spaceship keys. Because, well, who knows. I think a better question is, why wouldn't the hot dog vendor have a spaceship key? And that's the thing that costs so much money. The funny thing is, you can actually buy more than one spaceship key. Like, I could just keep buying spaceship keys. As if I'm gonna lose the rest of them or something. And let's buy a couple hot dogs, because why not? I'm rich. I mean, what else is there to do when you're rich other than buy hot dogs? Give to charity? Oh god, we're blind. Crap. I should have Mystic Meated. Ah, it doesn't matter. Alright, let's go to space. And we're there. I keep paranoidly looking over at my recording to make sure it is actually recording. It is actually recording. You know, when I played before, in my lost recording, one of the things I never found was the third sage key, or sage token, rather. And that really, really bothered me, because I really wanted it. So now I'm kind of paranoidly looking around for anything I've missed to see if I can find the third sage token, because maybe it's here. I'm trying to see if there's any, like, hidden pathways. Nope, doesn't seem like it. Nope, we gotta go up here. Alright. Yeah, I guess I'm still not gonna find the third sage token. Alright, so I'm blocked by these, like, robot creatures. Entering the palace is forbidden. Leave now or be destroyed. However, they don't actually hurt me, and in fact, I can just, like, crush them in an instant, somehow. I don't know how, but they just instantly die. Very strange. I'm like a mass murderer at this point. Just like mowing over dozens and dozens of these creatures who don't even seem to be trying to hurt me. It's really bizarre. Makes me wonder if my character is actually a bad person. And that everything I'm doing in this game is wrong. And I don't know about you, but this looks like the person that you play as during the intermission screens. This person laying on the ground. They can even talk to you, too. Turn back. It's terribly powerful. Despair, desire inside. It's delicately poopagaris? What? Alright, that's nonsense. Yeah, use the final crystal and a bunch of other crystals appear all around you, for some reason. Alright, so this is the final encounter here, this very, very creepy person. So let me go ahead and save. And let me make sure everybody's restored to full as well. So let's use a bunch of juice boxes. Sam's nose is a little bit hurt, but that's fine, just barely hurt. I also think I picked up some stuff I probably need to equip, like the horse. Yeah, believe it or not, you can actually equip the horse. Chitin Jerkin is type of garb. Let's put that there. And I think the horse is a shield, weirdly enough. Yeah, it's actually a deflector, the horse, which increases Somsnos's mightiness by like 20. So somehow you use a horse as a deflector and it increases your strength. And apparently also increases your chance of preemptive attack. I'm not even going to try to answer how that works because I don't know. And what about your deflector? Alright, so there's also the buckler that I got from the roach, but it's actually worse than the artificial bicep that Pongorma already has, so there's no reason to use that. And Wayne and Dedis cannot use it because they can't use a deflector because they are dual-wielding weapons. So I think that's some good equipment. Save again. Alright, fight me. You dare approach me? My vacuums will extrude your mountains until you beg me to indulge. Now, castigate thine pupagaris gland. It is the last time you will. Okay, yeah, I'll make sure to do that. I love the music for this boss fight. It's so strange, but ominous. Alright. So I actually need to take out the statues on the side first. Pretty important. So let's open up with Mystic Meat just to ward us against any bad effects. Then let's do a bunch of Dark Flame to AoE the statues to death. Let's also partial destruct Gibby, the main boss, because it's the most effective to partial destruct early on, because it does more damage, because it does 25% of the total... It does damage equal to 25% of the target's total health. So the earlier you do it, the better. Let's ward ourselves, do a couple AoEs. Get rid of the statues, and then once the statues are down, we can focus on Gibby. Yeah, Gibby is very strong. Gibby does a lot of damage. I would health chant, but Somsnosa doesn't look like Somsnosa is the only one that's really hurt. Everybody else is pretty much fine. So I don't know if I want a health chant. Maybe I'll just vegetable Somsnosa. Yeah, let's do that. Once again, Dark Flame. Why don't you vegetable yourself? That sounds like a euphemism. Go vegetable yourself. I'm gonna keep partially destructing Gibby. Again, the earlier you do it, the more effective it is. That ancient odor did like nothing because we're warded against status effects. Alright, come on, we gotta take out these statues. Keep dark flaming. Why don't you mystic meat again, because I think it's about to wear off. Dark flame. You need more mana, so why don't you juice box? Come on, statues, die! Man, these statues do not want to die. Let's keep dark flaming. Let's do a health chant. Juice box yourself. Partial destruct on Gibby. Okay, statue on the right is dead. Statue on the left is still alive, I think. Or no, I think the one on the left is dead too. Oh my god, did it just heal for 1,000? I think it did. Jesus. Yeah, so the statue on the left is still alive. Alright, we're all pretty low on will, so I am actually going to use a juice pack, which will restore everybody's will to full. And let's just beat up on the statue on the left. Come on, kill that damn statue. Cosmic Procession. Ooh, I think this is really harmful. Like a bad AoE, I think. Yeah, oh. That's a really bad AoE. Oh, another AoE? Oh my god. And the statue on the left is still not dead. Alright, we gotta do, like, 2 health chants. Alright, that should work. Let's, just normal attack the statue, I guess. Add partial destruct, Gibby again. Yeah, the statue on the left keeps healing. That's the bad thing. Uh-oh, we're confused. I need a mystic meat. Yeah, the statue keeps healing. We need to focus fire on it completely. Oh, we're taking a lot of damage. Alright, health chant. Or did I mystic meat? What did I do? Is everybody stunned? Because I only had like one turn there. Oh god. Come on, heal! Use a warm burrito on Somsnosa. Do another health chant. Jesus, stop dying. Oh god, I need to Mystic Meat. I need to heal and Mystic Meat, that's the problem. I think I'm gonna lose. Fuck, the stat- oh, this is- I'm doing this terribly. The statue's healing so fast, I'm just wasting my time even trying to beat up on it. Yeah, I've totally messed up this boss fight. Wow, I did pretty well the first time, in the recording that I lost, but... yeah, I just healed for 1,000. No. Nope, nope, nope. Dang. I need to focus fire on the statues even more. Like, forget AoE, I think. I think I just... need a space shuriken in them. Yeah, I think I do. Whoa, I have 101 meat. When did I get so much meat? Well, that just made me a lot more powerful. Well, I don't think we're gonna have any problem with the boss fight now. Alright, let's do this again. Yeah, look at how much health we have now. Oh, we're gonna be fine. Alright, so let's start out. Once again, with the Mystic Meat, it's very important to have that running always, or you are screwed. And then instead of AoEing, I'm just gonna Space Shuriken on the statues. Oh, that's right, you don't have Space Shuriken. I guess Dark Flame's fine. You also don't have Space Shuriken. Dark Flame. Space Shuriken, Space Shuriken, Dark Flame, Dark Flame. Need to focus fire on the statues. Yeah, because it just healed for 150, so you really do need to do a lot of damage, otherwise it's going to heal faster than you can hurt it. The statue on the left seems to be a lot hardier than the one on the right. The one on the right, like, never seems to heal as far as I've noticed. Right, once again, Space Shuriken. Space Shuriken. Attack, attack. I can't take time to juice box or anything like that. I need to kill it before it heals. There we go. Okay, it's dead. The one on the right should be no problem now. Another bad AoE. Is this gonna kill us? No, but it's close. Okay, we need to heal. Yeah. So... we need everything. Hot dog restores 50% of flesh to all allies. Let's actually do that. That's gonna heal us quite a bit. Then we also need the juice pack to get all of our will back. Then we also need to guard ourselves with Mystic Meat. Oh right, but I don't have the will for that. Let's redo this. So actually, Wayne. Wayne, you Mystic Meat. Dedis, you hot dog. Samsonosa, you Juice Pack. Pangorma, you... Throw a frozen burrito at the statue on the right. Oh, I killed the statue with a burrito. Yes, use the power of the hot dog! There we go, beautiful. Okay, so now we can focus fire on the main enemy. Statues are down completely. So let's bubbles to make it queasy. Let's kind of try to debuff it. Let's health chant. Let's just do a normal attack with you. And one thing I always need to be doing every turn, if possible, is keep using Partial Destruct. Again, it's very, very effective, especially when it has a lot of health left, because it deals 25% of its health in damage, so let's keep doing that. Oh, this is a really harmful AoE here. I hope Pangorma doesn't die. Nope, okay, we're good. Just keep beating it up. Space Shuriken. Space Shuriken. Drain, I guess? That's a heal and damage. I don't think it does amazing damage, though. Just normal attack, I guess. Actually, no. Go back. Let's actually have you use the juice box on Pangorma. Okay, so I think it's almost dead. I think it's only got, like, 300 hit points or something, or less. So if we all beat up on it right now with Space Shurikens, I think we can kill it. It's Partial Destruct. Partial Destruct is probably pointless at this point. Just do normal attack. There we go. Okay. Whew. A bajillion experience, and bucks. And I found a hot dog. Yeah, so now you gain levels, even though I don't think levels really existed in the game before. But now everybody's level 63, which basically means that at this point you're kind of invincible. You have like literally 4,000 hit points, I think. So, I am defeated. Wayne. I'm sorry about everything. By the way, Hrgrgrk, I set this moon to explode when I die. I love... It's the best reading of that sound effect ever, Hrgrgrk. I set this moon to explode when I die. Say your prayers, and hoist your vacuums. Like... Jelly Hope. What? Okay, cool, bye. Everything's exploding, I need to run. Run. And it looks like we died with the planet, but no, there's a little light you can see, traveling back to the other planet. That's us and our spaceship. And I think that's supposed to say our Wayne instead of or Wayne. Our Wayne, small, mostly adrift, works the doom. Above the sentimental concavity science. I'm pretty sure that text is different from how it was last time I played this, so I think it is randomly generated. At least partially. Yeah, this is actually different from what it was before. Which means it's complete nonsense. Amidst the crystals, I convexity smears wrongfully. Or sorry, a convexity smears wrongfully. Or may my nerve approach out of pains. So ends the tale of the Hollow Tyrannies, who sought to destroy, so sort of ostensibly approached their shrunken being.
It doesn't mean anything.
Don't try to understand it. Or, at least, make your own understanding of it. Invent something. Because I don't think there's a concrete enough story to really latch on to anything in particular. Alright, so we return. Our spaceship has just crashed here. And if you remember, I've actually been here before. This is, this poor fellow here is the person who wanted me to not press the buttons. He was really, really annoyed at me pressing the buttons. And there's only one thing left to press. The end. Alright, so there we go. Yeah, sorry for the awkward ending, the fact that the last episode was not a blind playthrough. I know it's very awkward. Kind of spoilery, you know, more of a... less of an authentic experience and more of a walkthrough kind of feel to it. But there's really nothing I can do about that. If only I could reverse time and make myself not mess up the recording. But it happened. And I had to deal with it, and I don't know, I think it worked out okay. Hopefully this last episode wasn't terrible, even if it did feel pretty different from the other ones. And I believe if I leave here and then come back, I think the credits actually start. Huh, that's weird. See, I left, and then I came back to this place a while ago. After a while. And something happened. Like, it actually started a list of credits to appear. Like, maybe if I go on this boat and then come back? Let's see if it does it now. No. Huh. Oh, there we go. Okay, now it's starting. Maybe just need to keep flipping the switch for it to happen. Yeah, there we go. So let her start moving and then you get the credits. Okay, so just something I want to mention is one thing that I did not actually find, which I guess I think I mentioned this before, but I didn't find the third Sage token, which is something I really wanted to find. I wanted the third Sage token so I can put it in that receptacle and go see what's on that TV. I really want to know what's on that TV. And in the episode that I messed up the recording for, I did actually go look for it. I looked for the third Sage token and I was unable to find it. So I just want to say that if anybody knows where the Sage token is, please do tell me. I would love to know where it is. And I would gladly go get it and see what it does and record it and do a special kind of, you know, post-episode, like little special just to show you what it does as well. Because I really want to know. So if you know where it is, please do tell me. This is just a little ghost creature that says, hey, there isn't anything more. Do you want to go to the main menu? No, I don't. So yeah, just to sum up my thoughts on this game, it's really, really good, actually. I was first interested in it just because the art style looked so fascinating that I just wanted to... I just wanted to stare at the game, basically. It just looks really fascinating. And what I found is a game that is even more interesting than I thought it would be, and also a heck of a lot longer than I thought it would be. To be honest, I think it's kind of underpriced, really. Because at the moment, the price for it is $3. And it said it was about 2 hours, which already, 2 hours, you know, a 2 hour game for $3 is already pretty freaking cheap. But in reality, this game for me, playing it as a mostly completionist, but not entirely completionist, kind of playstyle. It took me like 5 hours to complete. It would take you even longer if you were a complete completionist and really, really, really looked exhaustively for the third Sage token and killed every enemy possible. It could be longer. And I think if you were pretty fast and didn't explore too much, you could probably do it in like 3 to 4 hours. But still, it's a seriously long game. Like, a lot of work has been put into it. I'm really surprised it's so cheap. I honestly think it should be more expensive. And it just... it feels like such a homemade thing, you know, in the art style. The art style is so beautifully homemade and handcrafted feeling. It's wonderful. It's really beautiful. Even though it's kind of harsh on the eyes, it's also beautiful at the same time. and I can just feel the creativity in everything in the game. It's such a unique thing, and it just feels like so much love and handcraft has been put into the whole thing. It's really beautiful. So, that has been Hylics. I hope you enjoyed joining me on the adventure, and thank you for watching.